They're small, they're unusual, and they're helping older Americans age in place, kind of. Jane Wells tells us about Granny Pods from Oakland, California.
We have a living room, dining room with large windows for light.
67-year-old Jane Baldwin is on the move, making a big change.
How's your health?
My health is perfect now that I've gotten my second hip replaced.
Baldwin raised a family in Wyoming, but now her son is raising his own family in Oakland, California, and she wants to be close to help, but not too close.
That wouldn't work long term, living with my son under the same roof.
Instead, she built a tiny 400-square-foot house in her son's backyard, nicknamed a Granny Pod. The Census Bureau predicts 1 in 5 Americans will be over the age of 65 by the year 2030, and most of them will eventually need some sort of assisted care. There isn't enough assisted living to meet demand.
Have you figured out where everything's going to go?
Not at all.
So architects have discovered a new niche business, Granny Pods. The ones that Carrie Shores builds for Inspired Independence cost $250,000, which is still cheap for Bay Area housing. And seniors are often buying them to plan ahead.
I met with this family the other night. Their adult son would live in the in-law unit, but we're designing it age in place so that when they're tired of maintaining their home and the large property that they're not using or climbing up the stairs, they'll move in there. And at that point, he might be married and have kids, and he'd move into the main house.
Laws in 6 states now specifically allow granny pods, but in many cases they have to be temporary structures. This one is a permanent one. And because they're so expensive, if it's only temporary, it may not be for everyone.
If people can age in place and age at home, it's much healthier and the family's happier, but it can be very expensive. Granny pods can cost anywhere from $100,000 to $250,000, so you've got to weigh longevity in there with it.
Carolyn McClanahan also says they may not be right for a parent with dementia who needs more intensive care. These structures may also raise your property taxes. And then there are the neighbors. In Baldwin's case,
I have plenty of storage.
Her structure is under 500 square feet, so zoning laws did not require neighbor approval.
I looked forward to living smaller. I just think all of us, but myself in particular, have too much stuff in our lives.
For Nightly Business Report, Jane Wells, Oakland, California.